Carrie Rhodes here. Welcome back to my stamp studio here in Eagle, Idaho. Today I am bringing you episode 3 of my January 2020, it's 2020 now, stamp set of the month series featuring the Peekaboo Balloon stamp set by Avery L. Each week I am bringing you new ideas with the stamp set because it's one that I love. And today's card, I really wanted to put two hot air balloons on, so I made another slimline card. It's like my current favorite thing to make, and the two hot air balloons fit on there perfect. And I'm also going to be using some products from Arteza, some watercolors and their water brush pens for this card. So let's get started. Starting my card today by watercoloring a background onto Canson watercolor paper and using the Arteza 36 pan set of watercolors. Here's the swatch card that comes with it. I'll be using indigo, Prussian blue, and steel blue to create a nighttime sky. This watercolor set comes with a water brush. However, I'm going to be using a larger paintbrush today just because I have such a large area that I'm trying to watercolor. So here's the brush now, and I'm going to use the little pan to mix the color, not with other colors necessarily, but just with a lot of water to make it nice and thin. This is the darkest color I'll be using, so I'll be applying that at the top of my paper and bringing it down about one third of the way. This is Canson watercolor paper cut to about 4 1/4 by 9 1/2 inches. So it is larger than the finished size, just so that I could tape it down to this clipboard for painting. And then I'll trim it down to the exact card front size once it's dry. So you can see here, I'm just adding in the next color of blue, again, adding lots of water to it. And I'm filling up the next one third of the card, the middle third of the cardstock. And then my lightest blue will be for the bottom half. And I will just try to blend those out a little bit and repeat the process just to get a nice fluid blend between the colors, kind of an ombre look, and it will help it look like it's, you know, dark at the top and lighter at the bottom. And then I decided to go ahead and heat set that and add another layer. If you see some blotchiness in my background, that's because I touched it before it was dry, but it's gonna be fine. I'm gonna just add some layers and keep going. So I'm just wanting to darken this and intensify it and get a better blend. So I'm just gonna keep going, adding the different layers and just having fun with it. It's really satisfying to sit and paint a simple background like this. I'm not too worried about the kind of streakiness of the lines in my painting. For this, I feel like it kind of looks like how I wanted my sky to look, what was in my mind, but you could easily be a little bit softer with your lines. All right, so I'm going to heat set that again, and I thought that's where I was going to be done, but no, I wanted it still darker, so I'm coming in with a third layer of all the colors. And then before I dry it this time, because this is for sure my last layer, I'm going to take my distress sprayer and just spritz that with water, and that just softens out those streaky lines, and I feel like it just adds a dimension to the look. So I dried that, and then I'm gonna just set that aside while I go ahead and stamp out my images with some VersaFine Onyx Black ink. And I am adding some little critters, some Peekaboo Pals, into the balloons. So here you can see the Peekaboo Pal stamp set. I'm using the sloth and the panda. And look at their cute little paws. I love it. So stamping those onto Bristol smooth paper because I am going to be coloring them in with the Arteza water brush markers. Here they are right here, real brush pens. And they have this set of 48 that I find very versatile. Lots of color choices in there. So here's the colors I will be using. I will put them up on the screen for you. And I am gonna be coloring the balloons in one color. I remembered I like to heat set my VersaFine ink if I'm going to be using water. So there, I heat set it real fast. So here is my first yellow color. I'm going to be using two yellows for this balloon, but what I really wanted was the look of the balloon glowing from the inside, and I decided I wanted to maybe replicate the look of when you color a candle and you have the rings of yellow like radiating out from the flame. That's kind of where I got the idea for this. So the outer edge is that darker yellow, and then I came in with a lighter yellow, and I can blend with these markers. I can blend over the top of the last color. So that's what I did, and then I'm going to take my water brush pen with a, this one has a very thin point to it, and I squeeze out the water through the tip, but then I dab it off on my paper towel like that, because I don't want a ton of water. I want a lot of control here, just so I can soften out and blend those lines. Now, I didn't want this to look exactly perfectly blended because the light is coming from a flickering flame inside there. So I hope that's the look that I am portraying here. You let me know what you think. All right, so for the basket, I have two different shades of brown here, and the darkest being this chocolate marker. Gotta love a chocolate marker, right? That's always going to be a good color, one you'd use lots of times. So I'm doing my darkest areas with that, and then I'll be blending that out with the ginger marker almost all the way to the center, but then I will come in with the water brush and soften that out and blend it with the water. And again, you don't want to use a lot of water if you're using Bristol smooth paper. It's not a type of paper you would watercolor on, but it can withstand a little bit of water. So that's what I'm doing here, just blending that out so it has the same feel as the top of the balloon. I could have done the basket with just the markers, but I wanted all of these elements that are colored to have the same look and feel. All right, so for balloon number two, I've sped it up quite a bit, but I am doing the exact same thing with two different shades of orange and then blending that out with my water brush. And you can see I didn't take the color all the way to the edge. I wanted it to be lighter at the edge, and that helps it appear to be round. And then the basket done the exact same way with the same two brown markers. Now for my panda, I'm using a very dark gray called Ash Black and coloring him in. If I used straight up black, it would lose some of the detail on this image, like his eyeballs. So a dark, dark gray is going to work really good on this little guy. And I'm just outlining the eyes and that one portion under his chin, and then blending that out with my water brush. And it still, in the end, gives the feel of it being a panda and being black. And I'll do the paws the exact same way. And then for the sloth, I'm bringing back that ginger color, and this will be the only marker I use on this little guy. So I'm outlining that, and then I'll bring in my water brush to blend that out so he's a really kind of soft tan color. I didn't want to leave his face completely white, so I took that same marker, rubbed some onto my glass mat, and picked it up with some water, creating a much lighter shade or tint of that color. So blend that in, and he's ready to go. Time to die cut everything. I'll die cut those and set them aside because we'll come back to this background and remove it from the hardboard now that it's completely dry, and we're going to trim off the excess on those edges so that this will now measure 9 1/8 by 3 3/4. And that's going to fit my slimline card. So in the end, my slimline card folded up will measure 9 1/4 by 3 7/8. So that means I started with a piece of cardstock that was 9 1/4 by 7 3/4, and I scored it at 3 7/8. Now I know everybody has a little bit different size measurements for their slimline cards. So long as it fits into a legal size envelope, you're fine. That's what it is, a card for a legal size or business size envelope. All right, so I'm embossing some stars. These two star stamps are from the Peekaboo balloon stamp set. So I'm embossing those just to enhance the nighttime feel of the sky. Now at the end of this video, I am going to show you the card I made first with a little bit darker sky, and I want you to tell me which one you like best. All right, so for the bottom of this card, I have the Little Town Hillside pop-up add-on die set from Lawn Fawn that I cut with two different shades of gray and one from black. And I'm trimming those up and strategically stacking them to create a little bit of a town or village scene, and then I'll glue those on. So for now, I'm not putting glue behind the houses. I'm just gluing down the ground part and sliding those in behind each other very quickly before the glue dries. And then I can trim off any excess that hangs off the edge. And then I will go back and put some glue under those rooftops and press them down on all of the layers. Now I have a piece of grass cut from some dark green cardstock. This is using a die from the Mushroom Border stamp set by Lawn Fawn, and I'm stamping that with Sending Thanks, one of the sentiments in the Peekaboo Balloon stamp set. And I will emboss that with white powder so that it pops and stands up off of that dark green cardstock. I'll glue that onto the bottom of my card and trim off any excess that is hanging off the edge. And then I also made sure I rubbed off any of that anti-static powder tool that makes it look so dusty. So that is centered, and now I can trim off those edges. I wanted to add a little interest to the balloons, so I took some Altenew ink. This is Honey Drizzle, a really dark golden yellow, and taking one of the hearts from the Peekaboo Balloon stamp set and stamping right onto the balloon to give it some detail. I'll repeat that using Fire Brick ink for my orange balloon. And I didn't get these as straight as I wanted. I'm not going to hide that from you, but it's okay. Right? It's a handmade card. It doesn't have to be perfect. Next, I'm going to bring back those markers, the two darkest markers for each of these balloons, and I'm going to color in the scallops just to give a little bit of dimension to the balloon, and that really helped me be satisfied with my one color on each of these balloons. Just adding those little details made them a little bit more exciting. Now it's time to glue in the critter. So I am putting the sloth into the orange balloon, a little bit of glue at the base, and then a little glue on the back of his head, and he fits and sticks into that balloon really well. And the panda gets the yellow balloon. Then I'm going to add their paws, and then I also die cut a heart using a die from the Peekaboo Pals die set. It does have a matching stamp that goes with it, but I just wanted the die-cut heart. I thought it would be cute to have them holding something, and so I tucked that in behind his paws. I'll repeat the same thing with the panda. He'll be holding a heart too, but this time I got a little bit smarter, and I glued the heart down first, and then his paws, and that was easier. So learn from me, but you know, sometimes you think of it after you glue your paws down, so it can go on either way. And there we have our two super cute ballooners. I'm going to glue down the sloth's balloon in the upper left corner of my card front, and you can see there's just a few stars starting to appear in the night sky. And then for my panda, I will stick him on with some foam squares. Now I'm using that heavy block there because when you're gluing something onto watercolor paper, it does need a little bit extra holding time. So the block is helping me there so I can do all these foam squares. So that one will get popped on, and I love this card because it reminds me of an event that we have here in town where they have the hot air balloons go, they don't launch all the way into the air, but they do have them lit up at night, and you can go down and check out all the balloons, and they're just tethered to the ground. Super fun event. So I had to make a nighttime sky. All right, so I'm gluing that on to this navy cardstock. So it's got a dark blue edge. I love that. Just helps draw the eye in. And then a little accenting added to the balloons to give them a little shine with a white gel pen. And I'm just trying to stay in the darkest areas of the balloon with that gel pen. And that really helps add to the look of them being round and them being shiny. Love it. All right, now for the black gel pen, I'm going to color in their noses and their eyes to just intensify that black. And that finishes up the card. I had so much fun watercoloring. And I do love those Arteza pens. If you're going to use them, I highly recommend Bristol Smooth Paper. They work the best on that paper. Now, I also want you to make sure and take a look at this next card, same exact card, but you can see I started with black and then went to my navy color for the sky. So it's a little darker, but I didn't like how that played with the colors of the blue and I wanted more blue. But I would love to know what you think. Do you like the darker background or do you like the blue one? You let me know in the comments below. If you're new here, please subscribe. I will be back again next Tuesday with another idea with this stamp set. I will see you then. Happy stamping. Bye.